I want to speak about today or tonight a very important issue of dawah, and especially dawah to the Christians, because we are living in a country which is dominated by people who are belongs to Christian faith, and most of them are Catholics. And what can we convince them to Islam is their own book. Because if we tell them about the Quran, they say we don't believe in Quran. So what you can deal with them is the logic, the science, or the Bible. And that's what we call the comparative religion. We need to learn this very well. And of course, one of the great dawah is Quran. But before you can bring them to Quran, you have to convince them the Quran is the book of Allah, the book of the Creator. And you can also bring them to the oneness of Allah. For me, if we are making da'wah to a Christian or a non-Muslim, for me it's more important to him to believe in one God than to convince him to become a Muslim. More better, more important to convince him that he should worship one God. So at least if he is dying, at least he is dying in belief in one God and not worshipping idols and not worshipping many gods. Our main focus should be La ilaha illallah, there is no God except Allah. And we have to convince non-Muslims to come to one common term, the first common term, which is there is no God except Allah. This is Allah said in Surah Al Imran that Ta'alu ila kalimatin sawa'i bainana wa bainakum alla na'budu illallah. That come to the common term between you and us, that we should not worship any God beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Christians or Catholics, which is the most number in the world today among the Christians. The Protestants are less numbers than the Catholics. Catholics are more. Philippines is a Catholic country, in America, in Europe, and many other countries of the world, there are lots of Catholics, and they call themselves Roman Catholics. So if you talk about the logic, or you talk about the science, or we talk about the Bible, the most effective for a Christian is the Bible. Because every Christian, he believes and he respects the Bible. Regardless, and without knowing that there is not one kind of Bible, there are many kinds of Bible. Just for instance, the two big religions in Christianity, the Catholics and Protestant, their books have a different numbers. Like the Catholic books, they have a 73. The Catholic Bible, they have 73 books. But in the Christian Bible, the Protestant Bible, they have only 66 books. But they both call themselves Bible and the Bible. So the Christian, the Catholic Bibles, 73 books. But the Protestant Bible, 66 books. Kulang pito. 7 books are lacking. And they call Bible and there's the Bible. Unless the Quran, when you go to the Quran, you go any country of the world, Quran is only one. But the Bible is a different Bible. Catholic different, Protestant different, Jehovah's Witness have a different Bible, or Ecclesiani Christo, I'm not sure what Bible they use, but the Seventh-day Adventists, they have a different Bible. Some use the King James Version, some use the Standard Version, Revised RSV, Revised Standard Version. The Jimmy Swaggart in America, he has a different Bible. Gideon's, and there are so many different kinds of Bible. Different kinds of Bible. And they keep on bringing in the new editions and new kind of Bibles. Yet they still believe in Bible. So for us to convince a non-Muslim, a Christian, to convince them to Islam, the number one instrument we have is the Bible. Because they believe in it. They respect it. And they want to follow it. If you read the Bible, if a Christian read a Bible with the sake of research, he will get the proof of Islam. He will know that Islam is true. Even the first commandment in the Bible, the only the first commandment. Because they have a very popular 10 commandments. Even the first commandments, it is 100% the same what we have a faith in one God. La ilaha illallah. Because the first commandment, the God is speaking to them, thou shalt not worship any God beside me. And the Catholics or Christians, the Protestants, the Seventh-day Adventists, whatever denomination in the Christian world today, they are failed to fulfill the first commandment. They are failed. Unless there are some individuals, they follow that, then later they can become Muslim also. But collectively, if you go to the church is contradicting the first commandment. When you go to the church, the Catholic church, the Bible says the first commandment, thou shalt not worship any God beside me. The God said, thou shalt not worship any God beside me. But when you go to the Catholic church, what the Catholic church tells you? The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. How many in this one? The Father, one. Son, number two. And the Holy Spirit, number three. That's three. Simple mathematics. If you say there's not three, then you have some mental problem. You need to see a psychiatrist. Because if I say one plus one plus one, and you answer there's only one, then you need to go to the hospital, look for a good psychiatrist, because you need to take some medication, because you have some hallucination. You have some kind of illusion that you say, when you somebody tells you one plus one plus one is three, you say, no, no, there's only one. So you have some problem in your brain, which need to be corrected. Need to change some chemical in your brain. So definitely, the Catholic Church or the Protestant Church, they failed in the first commandment. Thou shalt not worship any God beside me. And that is the same first commandment in Quran. There is a one great scholar from Ahle Bayt, Imam Jafar Sadiq. He asked a very good question. Tell me the sentence, a kalima, a sentence, the half of it is a disbelief. And the second part of it is a 100% monotheism. Monotheism means beliefs in one God. And the answer is, la ilaha. What is la ilaha? If you say, if you don't say illallah, you say la ilaha, no God. You are a disbeliever. If you don't complete it, you are a disbeliever. Because you say there is no God. You are atheist. You are a kafir. But when you say illallah, then you are 100% mawhid or monotheist. A believer. A Muslim. So la ilaha illallah. La ilaha is zero. You are saying no God. Zero God. And illallah, only one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you go to the computer, in the computer language, what is in the computer language? Zero and one. Zero, one, zero, one, zero, one, zero, one. All the programming, one and zero. Zero is no and one is yes. All the computer works on these two digits. Zero and one. All the software, everything is work on zero and one. And what is the Quran, what is our kalima? La ilaha, no God, zero. Illallah, except only one. And that is the first commandment in Bible also. Thou shalt not worship any God beside me. And if you come to the New Testament in the Bible, which is this 10 commandments from the Old Testament, from Torah. But if you come to the New Testament, and then the New Testament, when the Pharisees asked to Jesus Christ, to Isa al-Masih, we called him, or in Pakistan, they called it Yusuf Masih. Very beautiful word, Yusuf Masih. But in Quran, Isa al-Masih. But they Englishized it to Jesus Christ. But it was Christos, and then make it Christ. So they make it like American Jesus. Or English, or European Jesus, which is not the word in Middle East. Even today, if you go to Middle East, they still call Isa. If you go to Palestine, the Christian in Palestine, they call Isa. And they don't call Mary is Mary, they call Mary Maryam. They don't call it Abraham, they call Ibrahim. Even the priest in the Church of Nativity, few years ago I was watching TV, the priest's name is Ibrahim. Same like in the Quran, Ibrahim. So the name was changed by the people. So they, Yusuf become Joseph, or Jacob become Jacob. So they change. Like I was discussing about the one of the prophet Shuaib, which is in Quran. They make it Jethro. What is Jethro? You are changing the name of the prophet. Shuaib become Jethro. So they are corrupting the names of the prophets of Allah. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said in the Quran, first commandment is La ilaha illallah. Everywhere in the Quran, what is the most important topic in the Quran, and which shows that the Quran is the book of God, the most important topic in the Quran is Tawheed, oneness of Allah. There is no God except only one God. If you go to the Old Testament, the first commandment, thou shalt not worship any God beside me. If you come to the New Testament, then when the Pharisees asked to Jesus Christ, Isa al-Masih, tell us what is the first commandment or the greatest commandment. And then Jesus Christ said in the Aramaic language, which is same like similar to Arabic, and He said, Shama o Israelo. Shama is Sama. Sama in Arabic, here. Sama means here. But in the Hebrew, in Aramaic, Shama. Like we say Salam. But in the Hebrew, in Aramaic, they say Shalom. They say the scene is Shalom. So he said, Shama Israelo, hear O Israel, Adonai Elohino, Adonai Ahad. Hear O Israel, Lord our God is only one Lord. What the Christian need more than this? That Jesus said Himself, Lord our God is only one Lord. Is it Jesus is telling a lie? Or is he a not normal human being? Or is deceiving you? If he's a God, then why he said our God is only one God? What is the meaning of our God in English? My God and your God is only one God. That's the explanation of our God. Or in Tagalog, Diyos natin. It's meaning, Diyos ko at Diyos ninyo, isa lang Diyos. And that's what the Jesus Christ said. Shema Israelo, Adonai Elohino, Adonai Ahad. Adonai means is Lord or Rab or Panginoon. Elohino, it same like Arabic, we call Ilahana, our God. If I say Ilahi, my God. If I say Ilahana, if he said all of us, Ilahana, our God. Like Mawla. Allah, we call Allah is Mawla. If I say Mawla, ya, my Mawla. And if you say all of us, Mawlana, our Mawla, Allah is our Mawla, Allah is our patron, Allah is our ally, Allah is our protector. So the word Ilahino is similar, almost 99% same like Arabic. In Arabic, Ilahana, they say Ilahino, which means our God. So Jesus said, Hear, O Israel, Adonai Elohino, Adonai Ahad. Lord, our God is only one Lord. Isa lang Panginoon. Diyos, Panginoon, Panginoon Diyos natin, isa lang Panginoon. That's the first commandment. And the Christian, they fail to follow the first commandment. Jesus said, My God and your God is only one. But they say, No, you are the God. You, Jesus Christ, is the God. And they have a very, very funny explanation. What is the explanation? They said that the spirit of the God, you come to the womb of the Mary and enters in the body of the Jesus. So Jesus got the spirit of God, then he become God. So what happened now to God? When his spirit, according to them, is out, then the God is dead already. And the Spirit of God enters in the body of Jesus. So Jesus is alive. When the body of the Jesus is dead again, then the soul of the Spirit of God is out again. So what is this? Do God have a spirit? Do God have a body? No. God, si Diyos, walang spirit at walang katawan. Dahil tao lang may katawan at may espiritu. Meron tayong espiritu. Soul, kaluluwa, espiritu yan. So if the God have a spirit and the God have a body, then God is just a parang tao lang. He's just like a human being. That he has a body and soul or the spirit. So the spirit is not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but the spirit is a likha ng Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The spirit is a creation of Allah. And how Allah created it? يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الرُّوحُ قُلِ الرُّوحُ مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. They ask you about the ruh, about the spirit, about the soul. Say them that the ruh is from the command of your Lord, from the amr of your Lord. وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. And you are not given the knowledge, but very little. Very limited knowledge. So we don't know much about the spirit, but Allah is As-Samad. As I said in the earlier, Kullu Allahu Had, He is Allah only one. Allahu Samad. Allah is Samad means He is free from need of a body. He is free from need of a soul. He is free from a need of His creation. Wala siyang kailangan. So hindi kailangan siya ng katawan at hindi kailangan siya ng espiritu. At hindi kailangan siya ng lugar. At hindi kailangan siya ng oras. Wala siyang kailangan. This is meaning As-Samad. You don't need to make a limitation for Allah. Wala siyang limitation. Infinite siya. Walang hanggang, walang umpisa, walang katapusan. That's the meaning of Allah Samad. The idol, the false gods, they have a limitation. Allah is without limits. Without limitation. So Allah is not a body and Allah is not a soul. If you believe that, if you try to imagine Allah, that Allah has a face and Allah has an arm, big arms, and Allah has a legs, so you are imagining an idol, just ribolto. You are not worshipping Allah anymore. You have a giant idol in your brain now. You are thinking about the God with mental picture. Never think about Allah, never imagine Allah in your brain, because your brain cannot know who Allah is. Your heart cannot know who Allah is. And that is shirk. Whenever you make imagination of Allah, then how Allah look alike? He has what kind, what He look like, and you try to think about Allah has a face and Allah has a hands, then you are committing shirk. Because Allah is free from all needs. And He has no son and He has no father. وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. And there is no one is similar unto Him. وَلَا شَنْ كَتُولًا. وَلَا شَنْ أَنُمَنْ كَتُولًا. So He is not like a human. The God, Almighty Allah, hindi parang tao. Hindi parang langit, hindi parang lupa, hindi parang araw, hindi parang buwan. Anything you can think in your imagine in your brain, that's not Allah. If you can imagine circle, Allah is not circle. If you can imagine a square, Allah is not a square. If you imagine triangle, Allah is not a triangle. If you imagine a human or an animal or the sky or the sun or the moon or the star, Allah is not all of this. When Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, he was looking for Allah, he saw the star, he said, Haza Rabbi, that's my Lord. When the star disappeared, he said, no, I don't like the God which disappeared. When he sees the moon at the night, he says, Haza Rabbi. When the moon disappears, he says, I don't like the God who disappeared. And he sees the sun in the daytime, the very big sun, and he says, Haza Rabbi, Haza Akbar. That's my Lord, that's very big. And when the sun sets, he says, I only worship the God who created everything, who created the universe, who created the sun and moon, and who created all the human beings. So not to worship the creation, but to worship the Creator. Huwag na sambahin sa yung mga likha. Dapat sambahin kay yung tagapaglikha. So Prophet Isa alayhi salam, he preached to worship one God. Prophet Musa, Prophet Abraham, Prophet Noah, Prophet Adam, and the last Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam, all of them, what is the first commandment they have? La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah wa Adam is Safiullah. Adam is chosen by Allah. La ilaha illallah Ibrahim Khalilullah. There is no God except Allah, and Ibrahim is a friend of Allah. La ilaha illallah Musa Kalimullah. There is no God except Allah, and the Musa was the one who speak to Allah. And La ilaha illallah Isa Ruhullah. What is the meaning of Ruhullah? Isa is Ruhullah, or Isa is Kalimatullah, means Allah send the soul for him. And Isa is Kalimatullah, the Isa is the word of Allah, which we believe that the word of Allah, because Allah created him with his word. Likana Allah sa yung salita niya. Maging mangyari. That's salita, the kutus, the command. So word of Allah doesn't mean that the word become human, but word of Allah means that Allah created him without his sperm, without the father, just by his command, kun fayakun. Maging mangyari, be and it is. So that's how the Christian were misguided. They started to think about that the Jesus is God or Son of God or the Spirit of God, etc. Allah, the God Almighty, He has no body, no spirit. Because He made us in two components, body and the spirit. The spirit goes out, we die. And the spirit goes in, we are alive. So do Allah is like us? That merusha katawan at merusha kalulwa, that is shirk. Because you believe Allah is like us. If you are eating the food and drinking water and you think Allah needs to eat, then you're committing shirk. You sleep at night and you think Allah sleep, then you commit shirk because you make Allah like our level. So if you believe Allah is a son, that is shirk also. And if you believe Allah has a soul and Allah is a body, that is shirk also. And if you believe that Allah is a face and Allah is a hands, then you commit shirk also. You cannot make Allah compared to His creation. You cannot make Allah compared to His creation. Hindi siya wala siyang anuman katulad walam yakullahu kufuwan ahad. There is no one is comparable unto Him. Wala siyang comparison. You can compare to donkey to the horse. You can compare to the lion to the cat. You can compare the wolf to the dog. You can do this comparison. You can compare this person is look like this person. We were in China. We in the office in China, the DHL came. And the DHL, the Chinese person, when I saw his face, looked like Ustad, same. Kamukhang Ustad. Chinese, but looked like Ustad. Same color, same face, all. And even Salamin, same. So I see, oh, this DHL in China look like Ustad. So Allah make comparison for us. We look like with someone, but Allah is not look like anyone. He's not Indisha Tao. Hindi siya parang langit, hindi siya parang lupa, hindi siya parang hangin. You cannot compare Allah to anyone because He is unique. He is uncomparable. He is unimaginable. He is unestimated. You cannot estimate Allah. You can estimate anything, how great is He. For example, the universe is very big universe. Only the diameter of the universe is 93 billion light years. You travel with the speed of the light, 300,000 kilometers per second. You travel for 93 billion light years. That is the diameter of the universe. But it's still limited. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is unlimited. Universe is in front of Allah is smaller than atom only. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is unlimited. No limit for Him. No, He's infinite. So that's very important message that we can share with the non-Muslims. That you stop imagine, example, when you go to the Catholics, they make the picture. They're even making a picture of God. What is the picture of God? Old man wearing the throne, corona. Corona is throne. The corona today in the, talking about the COVID, corona means is crown. The throne. Not throne, crown. So they make the picture of God wearing the crown, gold crown, white hair, white beard, and sitting on the chair, and sitting beside him is a son, a young man with a beard, long nose, and then on the top of that there is a pigeon. Pigeon is a bird, kalapati. And that's the religion. Idol worship religion. They even imagine a God old man and the son is a young man, and the spirit is on the top kalapati, the pigeon. Subhanallah. That's their idol worship religion. A paganism, a pure paganism, or a pure paganistic religion which they are following. And they are abandoning the true religion of God, the religion of Abraham, which is Islam. That you only worship God Almighty Allah without any partner. So that's our message. Must be the foremost message. Rather than we are debating some other things, when you go to the Christian, when you have a good relation with him, some party, some dinner, some coffee, and even to share a water with a non-Muslim, then when you are close to him, then your first dawah is La ilaha illallah. The most important dawah is La ilaha illallah. There is no God except only one God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So inshallah, I am done now.
Thank you for watching. And please don't forget to share, like, subscribe, and comment.